Hello children, Europe geography lesson is completed now. We learnt about the Europe continent. Today I am going to start the history lesson. That is important dynasties of South India. Important dynasties of North India already we learnt in the first sem. In the second sem we are learning about the South India. South India, it is ruled by many important kingdoms. That one we are learning in this lesson. First is Satavahanas. That is the important dynasty, and it is the Kannada dynasty. In the South Indian kingdom, some are Tamil kings also is there. Pallavas, they are giving preference for the Tamil. But this Satavahanas are purely Kannada kings. Okay, their capital city is Paithan. Pratishtha, that is the capital city of the Satavahanas. It is in Maharashtra. And the greatest king among the Satavahanas are Gautamiputra Satkarni. He is the greatest king in the Satavahanas. See children, Gautamiputra. This is mother name. Gautami is the mother. Satkarni is the king's name. They are giving preference for the mother. So before their name they used to keep mother name. This is Gautami. Gautami is the mother. Putra means son. So Gautami Putra Satkarni. Followed. And greatest king in the Satavahanas are Hala, Pulanvi, Nagarika. These are the greatest king among the Satavahanas. Above the Gautamiputra Satkarni is the greatest king now. About him we learn now. Okay, this is there in your textbook children. Satavahanas kingdom, I will show.
See children, this much is the Satavahanas empire. From the South India, it is stretched to the west, up to the north of the India. Yellow part is there, no, all it is Satavahanas kingdom only. Empire they given in your textbook.
Okay. Gautamiputra Satkarni brought the glory for the Satavahanas, which was about to decline. When Gautamiputra came to the power, no, that time Satavahanas kingdom was very weak. It is about to lose the power. That time he taken the rule and he started administrating the kingdom as well as expanding the kingdom. So he is called greatest king. Then he defeated the foreign dynasties like Shaka, Yavana and Pallavas. These kingdoms he defeated. Then he reprinted his name on the coins of the Shakas. Shakas were the others. They minted their images on the coins. That one he needed, and he printed his own images on the coins of the Shakas. Then he extended his kingdom to the Konkan, Surakshara, then Malwa, Bihar. To all these places he extended Saurashtra. It is Saurashtra, Malwa, Bihar. To all this one he extended his kingdom. As he covered the south part, India's south part of the region, Arabian Sea is there. Here Indian Ocean is there. Here Bay of Bengal is there. So three seas are there. Samudra, Kannada word is there. Kannada people know Samudra means Kannada. So as he conquered the all the south part, up to Bihar he covered. Saurashtra now is his Gujarat. That one. All that he covered, so he got the title as Sri Samudra Toya Pita Vahana. Sri Samudra Toya Pita Vahana. Like this, he got the title. What is the meaning of this title? Pita Vahana means, Pita means drinking. That means the person who is having the horse which drank the water of three seas. That is the meaning of this title. Three Samudra Toya Pita Vahana. Followed, children? Yes. What are the contributions of the sadhanas? We'll see that one. Yes. About the religion means, these are Kannada people, children, Hindu people, they are, but they are following the Buddhism also. They embrace the Buddhism religion also. Many where they built the Buddhist centers. That one. See, especially they are following the Vedic religion, children. That is important. Vedic religion. How it is? In the first time we learned the culture of Vedic period. Greek Vedic period, how it is? Woman got more importance. The society was very pure. All good things were there in the society. No varna system, no caste system. Do you remember? Like that system is. So they are following that religion. Because of that religion, they given importance for the mother. Gautami Putra they kept before their name. So that religion they are following. And their gods are Pranameshwara Linga of Talagunda. That is their worshipable god. Pranameshwara Linga of Talagunda. That one they used to worship. Along with that, they built the Buddhist center in Nasik, Kareli, Kaneri, and Amravati. In these places, they built the Buddhist centers. Then, other than Pranameshwara Linga, they used to worship the Ganesha, Vishnu, and Surya. These gods they used to worship. Then, literature means they are following the Prakrit language. Prakrit was the main language. I read. Yes, I said, children, Prakrit was their main language and they encouraged the writers. Many kings there wrote the books. See, children, King Halaitis. King's name, Hala, is also one of the important kings. He wrote the book, Katha Sapta Sati. That book he wrote. Then, Gundaya, he wrote the book, Vadakanta. Book name, these are writer's name. Followed. Then, Sarva Varma is a writer. He wrote the book, Atantara Vyakarana. That book he wrote. These are the main books, children, which were written during the Sadhana's time. Main thing given in reference for the perfect language. King Hala wrote, Gata Sapta Sati. Then, Gundaya wrote, Vadakanta. Sarva Varma wrote the Katantara Vyakarana. Got it? Yes. And the given reference for education is said, for that purpose, they built the Agraharas. Agraharas, they are the learning centers, that one they built. And Talagunda of Shivamogga district was their main education center. Followed, this is about the literature of the Sadhanas. Next comes architecture. What architecture they built, that one? See, children, the contribution for the architecture is very much. They built the chaityas, vihars, and stupas. What, chaityas means what? Vihars, stupas means what? All that one, I will explain. They built the chaityas. Chaityas means they are the Buddhist prayer hall. They are great, the Buddhist religion, I said, no? So for the prayer, Buddhist prayer hall, they are called as a chaityas. Then vihars means where the Buddhist monk will stay. That Buddhist Swamiji will be there, no? their staying place is called as the Vihars. How we are calling Mata for Swamiji's, like that it is. Vihar, that is called. And they, many things they built here. Agrahas means that one learning centers there, that also they built. Then Chaitya at the Kareli of Maharashtra is very big and beautiful. It is a rock cut picture to the Kareli that they built that prayer hall of the Buddhists. Vihar it is called. Then five marble stupa is there, that is in Amaravati of Andhra Pradesh. Is known for its artistic carving. Five marble stupa, prayer hall of the Buddhist. Then architecture creations of the Sadhanas can be found in Kanakanahalli of Kalburgi district. In Karnataka also it is called. Then Banavasi of Uttar Kannada district. In these two places you can see many architecture creations of the Sadhanas. For our children, literature and the architecture. Trade during the Sadhanas children, that is very important one. For the purpose of trade only, the Sadhanas were improved their kingdom. How means the trade means business. The trade is carried out not only in the kingdom, outside the kingdom also. That means they are having the export-import business also. They are having the trade relation with the Rome children. In the Europe country, they are having the trade relation. And in the empire, many towns, many cities were trading centers, business centers. In India, how Bombay, Calcutta, Hubli, Gujarat, these are the trading centers. Many business will carry out here. Like that way, many towns were the trading centers, business centers there. They are called Nigamas. They are called as the Nigamas. Nigama means trading centers. Trading centers there. Like that it was. Then, in the business, we are having the association children. All merchants are having their own associations. Do you know this one? Even Ataman also, they are having their associations. Like that way, even merchants also, they are having their associations. Cotton Merchants Association. Like that will be. According to their profession, according to their specialization, Carpenter Association will be there. Like that, according to their profession, according to their skill, their caste, then you make the association. Same way, in the Sadhanas time also, the businessmen, according to their business, according to their speciality, they used to make their associations. That associations are called Shreni. They are called as the Shreni. Shreni means that association. For example, the grocery people, what the groceries they are selling on, all together they make one association. That association name will be Danika Shreni. Danika Shreni. Danya means civil civil. This is in the Danya only name, no? So, Danika Shreni is. Grocery association is. So, head of the Shreni, head of the association is called as the Srishti. He is called as the Srishti. Means he is the leader. The leader of the Shreni. He is the rich one. He is the dominating one in that association. Who is the rich businessman now? He will become the, or senior will become the leader of that Shreni, and he is called as the Srishti. Follow children? Yes. Once again I will repeat. This Sadhana spirit trade was very important occupation. Not only in the empire, outside the empire. That means import-export business they are having relation with the Rome. Then in the empire, many cities were trading centers. They are called as the Nigamas. Then according to their specialty, according to their professions, merchants they are making their own association. That associations are called as a Shreni. In that, the rich one, senior one will be the leader of that Shreni, that association, that person is called as a Srishti. For our children, Yes, this is all about their trade. How they used to carry out the business means they are using to move the cargo, to move the goods. They are using the bullock carts, horse, donkeys. All this one they are using for the movement of the goods. And they are having the trade with the many foreign countries, west and east coast of the empire. From the both sides they are having the towards the west and the east they are having the coastal. To that one they used to carry out the foreign trade. Yes, you are having new reason on the trade, children. That is, economic prosperity during Satavahanas was more. How? The reason is that one, the children. Because of their trade. Followed? Yes, this is all about the Satavahanas. 9 to 10 kingdoms we are learning in this chapter, children. Among the South Indian dynasty, nearly 9 or 10 kingdoms are given in your textbook. So every day I will take one kingdom only separately, then there will be no confusion. Okay. Yes, for today's class I will do the homework now.
Yes, homework for today.
What is the capital city of Satavahanas? Name the important kings of Satavahanas. Three kings' names I wrote it up, that you write. What are Chaitya and Vihas? Meaning of Chaitya and meaning of Vihar you have to write. What are Nigamas and Shreni? Meaning of Nigamas, meaning of Shreni you have to write. Which is the administrative language of Satavahanas? Prakriti is that you write. What title Gautami Putra Satavahani got? Name of the title you have to write. Yes, this much you write, children. In the next class, Kadambas is there. It is the first Kannada dynasty. That one we will learn. Okay? Thank you.